Hey everyone, how's it going? Gonna do another video here. And, deity, of course. What I'm gonna do this game is do absolutely nothing for 40 turns and see if I can come back and win. Never tried this before, so the outcome is gonna be a complete surprise. I did do a dry run just to see if it was even possible to sit still for 40 turns and do nothing, and it did seem that way. It's actually kind of a pain because your city starts growing, even you kind of can't even prevent it from doing certain things. You can't actually do nothing. You have to do some things, like your city's going to grow, you're going to get hammers in your city, or you'll get some science. So I'm just going to try to minimize that as much as I can. And the only question is, what civ am I going to play? Yeah, how about the French, actually? They're a terrible civ. Start with pottery and a cathedral, two things you don't need at the start of the game. So, it's going to be rough. So, I don't know. You're going to have to root for me on this one. I have no idea what's going to happen. I think I can win, but I wouldn't do a video I think I'm going to lose. But I do think I'm going to be fighting off a lot of Legion armies in the early going. My liege, we stand. Now the way this is going to work is I'm going to have to plant wherever I am as part of the rules, and kind of a weird, that's a terrible spot too. I got a hill right next to me, but we'll see what happens. Maybe it'll make it a little more interesting. Now, it's impossible to do nothing. The worst possible thing you could do is probably food. Because production is at least useful. I'm going to do food as much as I can. Once I grow to 3, I'm just going to have to do the minimal number of hammers that I can do. So let's see what happens. Up to 3 populations, so I'm just gonna bank hammers as much as I can. This is gonna be tough. 40 turns, it'll take you all the way to 0. So, let's see. Breaking in some cultures, I'm gonna get a great person. Great builder. That's a good sign. Where's he gonna hang out? Not allowed to settle him yet. Again, try to do nothing. So not even use the trees. However, you still get 1 production from the worker in the city, so. Up to 5 population. So at least my cathedral is doing something for me. 8 more turns. Wow, I got 2 great people in this time. That'll be an interesting decision. I'm not quite sure what to do with them yet. So 6 more turns. I'm gonna have to finish a wonder. I actually can't even prevent it. I mean, if I'm gonna finish a wonder on the 6th turn, I might as well go for the Hanging Gardens. It's gonna give me a pretty gangster city. Bring it up to 9 population. Alright, let's go for it. Question would that be the right decision? I mean, I could build Stonehenge, but kind of weird, huh? Anyway. Uh-oh. So yeah, one more turn. Nothing I can really do. Oh man, he took my hut. It's messed up. Alright, now I'm gonna. Now I have the chance to manage my city. Let's see. I guess I gotta get some units out there and start exploring, so. Japanese. See how much tech they have, probably going nuts. Six tech, it's actually not. It could be way worse, I've seen them go bananas. Never mind the Chinese. And they have their 100 settlers, so. I just need to get some bodies out there. So next turn, I gotta figure out what's around me. I don't even have anything to build with them. Nothing good. Good Russian settler. That's kind of silly. Alright. Wow, no one's got an alphabet yet. In all that time. Wow, I'm accidentally getting so much tech. That's funny. I'll go for that. That's amazing, I'm actually getting 7 tech per turn. Granted, it's the year 50 AD when I'm thinking about getting bombers, but damn, it's still pretty good. Thought about settling this guy, but I still don't think it's really worth it, and there's not really good food around me anyway. Might as well get something that gives me real benefits right now in the early going. Look at all those laborers and vendors. 8? Not bad. There's really nothing for me to there's nothing to do with this guy right now, so. Keep them going in one direction. It is the one bright side where the French do at least get some great people, so. Amazingly, we still have some barbarians hanging out. computer really sucks at cleaning up these huts. Who's out here? This is tough because there's like four ways I can go. I'm gonna go east. Explain why I'm not getting too much interference. Greek aren't gonna mess with you. Seem to have found the Japanese, or scouting around with an archer. And I'm just gonna do one more army. Not gonna do me much good. Maybe try to save it for something like great, the East India Company or something like that. Just need something that's gonna give me more substantive advantage, give me a capability to really regain all the time that I lost. Alright, so it looks like the Tokyo is right next to me. I mean, they are so close that my culture is actually appears to be affecting them a little bit. So we got some resources over here I could possibly take advantage of. That's good. Army these guys up. I don't really want them all gimping up like this. Getting close to another great person. Got a spy, so I could potentially use him to my advantage. Let's see if anyone has code of laws. Nope. So Romans are not in this game. The Chinese are not in this game. Literacy's not taken. Let's see what we got here. Aztecs. Greek are not gonna pop out a great person, that's for sure. Just gonna bank these hammers if I can for oops. Hopefully I can use it on settlers when the time is right. Trying to find some natural wonders, but it's not really happening. Alright, got a decent coastline. I could do some expansion along the coasts. Not too bad. Breathing room. Gotta get another great person pretty soon, so that'll be interesting. This turn. Ooh, Plato. He sucks. Not much. Wow. That's awesome. That is really awesome. Four population city. Really nice. Nice cultural flip right there. That was actually worked out. And I have an archer in there, so that's pretty damn good. Only two technology. Perhaps I could build me a boat. Oh, actually, I need a boat over here. Nothing yet, so just bank hammers for now. Trying to figure out if that's a coastline or not. I don't think I've hit a single natural wonder. I can't believe I flipped that. That was awesome. Finally. Alright, yeah, that's it. It's just looks like a dead end right there, so. 1, 2, 3. And I'm just gonna take these guys south. Another hut. Not worth the rush at the moment. Let's just get these guys out. And I may as well take these guys east, actually, since I control this territory. 500 AD. Got some Greek horsemen running around. Acting crazy. Nothing to build, really. Question is, which way would be more beneficial? Let's take them this way. We could get some valuable intel on the Japanese. Who knows what they're doing. Actually, a chance I could lose this. I need some veterans. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to use the spy to set up some expansions. Helps you if you position your guys ahead of time. Makes it a little bit easier to roll your expansion out. You can do the same thing with the great builder. I'm going to move him out too. And keep an eye on this. Well, the Greek can't get to me. They changed to despotism. Might have to keep an eye on him. Keep an eye on that horse. He could potentially swoop in and steal that very person. I don't think the computer would do that. Could happen, though. Never too early to start looking for your production city. Which may be right here. Four trees, two mountains, that's decent. It's probably the best spot that I can see. Other spots really interest me that much. Looking for a position where I could put a city in one turn where I would have three water, but I don't really see one aside from that one up there. Well, it's not always perfect. Looks like the Japanese got masonry, so I'm not going to worry about that. What's going on over here? I'm running around with some settlers, so I'm going to keep an eye on that. Just in case, gonna switch this up. And let me check what has been discovered so far. Well, I got a technology, it was just the wrong one. Do you know why that happened? Please tell me. I don't know. Usually you get the one that you're looking at. Not that time. Position these warriors up on the hill and may give me a little bit of a counterattack advantage in case they try to march in there. These warriors. That's actually very good. I'm actually, looks like I'm got a nice little peninsula I can take advantage of. Put a bunch of nice cities on there. This is really dicey right here. I don't think that's gonna work. You know why? I got a horse there waiting to kill me. Last thing I need is losing this army right here. It's too risky right now. And they may have a pikeman in there, so I'm not gonna mess with it. I haven't found the fourth sieve here yet. What can I build? Nothing cool. By sitting on the hill, you get a nice little sight bonus as well. So, that's where he's gonna hang out. So I think our only hope here is to expand like mad, have some really nice cities, and see if we can catch up to the Japanese. After stealing their city like that, I probably hurt them, so I think we got a shot here. Whoa, Aztecs have a bunch of cities. They have at least three. Alright, it's gotta straighten out this mess I've made here. Still only two cities. Time to start pumping out settlers. As fast as possible. That's what I was talking about. Oop. Keep yanking my focus around. Let's go back up here before we forget. Plant this guy. No gold to rush quite yet. That's a terrible spot for a city. There's nothing I can do about that right now.
Kim Poo.
About it for now. So I found a unit over here, hanging out, so I can't run Gilgamesh over there. Oh no, I hope they don't settle. That's gonna really screw me. Nothing I can do about it. Hope to get in his way. Nothing I can do. I may have to get a boat and start expanding. Like this little island right here. It's a nice one. Good find. Pretty simple to get back to Mother Base too. So, getting a few breaks here. Well, if they plant, maybe I can just steal that city. It's a good position. Hopefully they plant right there. It's actually a decent spot right here. There's no trees around here. I'm having a very hard time expanding effectively. This is going to have to be a city. Alright, wish me luck here. Golden Science. Could be worse, not too bad. someone got literacy. It's probably the Japanese. That's gonna hurt. Well, may need Bronze working, just in case they start getting aggressive here. Yeah, I'm still trailing, so certainly not. I'm not out of the darkness yet. Low on gold. City's position is so bad, I just don't even know what to do with it. Oh, heavy humanitarian. Or try to steal that. I'm glad I started looking at bronze working. So they declared war, but I don't see any movement yet, so I'm just going to chill for now. Some of these I'm going to swap over to technology. Not much else I can really do right now. It'd be worth moving these guys over here though. I have to consult this and see what's open for bonuses, if anything. Someone's got a currency. No one has math. Gonna go monarchy. Gonna have to work my way there, though. What a terrible spot. Nothing I can do about it. that's frustrating. Do this right. Could just go from monarchy and then go to feudalism. I think it's worth it. Stick with this. And also gonna go for gold so we can get one more free settler. So that'll help. Pretty nice find right there. What I should do is I should move one of these settlers over to these islands. And just expand as much as I can here. Oh boy. They're gonna try to sink my boat. Feudalism is a weed. It's gonna take a while. 9 turns, but I'm pretty close to turning this around here. Are they gonna attack me or not? I gotta wait. Let's see what this boat does. Nice. Alright. Gotta do something with those castles and